Can you hear me?
What sort of trick is this? That's not the boy.
That's not my son's voice.
Doctor, the voice. That's the voice that was in the dream with my mum.
Very good, Paige. And doctor, that is what you like to be called, isn't it? I knew the child would bring you to me. And I am not disappointed.
Really? I've been wanting to meet you as well. I could hear you in my mind, but simultaneously you could hear me. I suppose that makes sense. Who are you, and what are you doing with this child?
Why should I tell you anything? I am not here to negotiate terms with you. Merely to warn you.
Warn me?
You do not belong here. If you do not leave immediately, I will kill this boy. I will kill every human being here.
You will do no such thing! And I have no intention of leaving these people to whatever it is you have planned for them. On the contrary, it is you who will leave immediately. Well, I promise you, I will be involved. And you won't like it a bit when I get involved. Not one bit.
Very well, Doctor. Have it your way.
Doctor, grab him. Grab him before he makes him jump off.
Goodbye, Doctor.
Jeremy!
Jeremy! What was he going on about? That didn't even sound like a kid's voice.
Jeremy!
Do you have him? Doctor?
Nothing makes sense here anymore.
Oh, I think he'll be just fine. I have him right here. Passed out from the fright, it looks like.
Oh, thank goodness. Are you okay, Jeremy? Please wake up. Doctor. Doctor, what's going on? Why was he talking like that?
Mom? Dad? Is that you?
Jeremy, we thought you were... What happened? Are you okay?
Well, what, Dad? What are you talking about?
We thought we were going to lose you. But you're all right now.
Carly! Doctor! You all right?
What? What are you doing? Get away from those two, Jeremy!
Why? Mom, the doctor and Carly have been really nice to me this whole time.
And they're also the same people that butted into our business without so much as a buy or leave. They probably were what caused you to talk in that nasty voice. And furthermore, I would like to know how both of them seem to know so much about what's going on. Jeremy didn't even recognize me. Or his father. Heavens above, Doctor, you seem to be enjoying this.
Madam, I will admit that I'm intrigued by the situation. But I do not happen to enjoy young children being put into mortal danger.
Alice, stop it. He just saved Jeremy from jumping off that terrace. The least you can do is be thankful that our boy is safe and sound.
That's for sure.
What did you say?
Nothing. But the doctor's telling the truth. We honestly don't know what's going on, and that's why it's even more important that we figure it out. We don't want Jeremy to get hurt. Ah!
Alice!
You stay out of our business. The electricity going out and everything was bad enough, but nothing really bad began to happen here until you two showed up. And now you've gotten my darling little boy involved. Talking in strange voices, not listening to his own parents. And anyway, how long have you been doing this sort of thing? Coming in and disrupting people's lives. Don't you think your doctor is a bit old for you, girl?
Alice! Carly, doctor, I'm so sorry. I don't know why she...
Now see here! We were just trying to help Jeremy, as he's a rather nice young chap. And whatever is happening is tied to this place somehow. Not to the two of us, I assure you.
You would say that, you cradle robber.
One more word.
Madam, I would ask for an apology. But I know your words come from exhaustive fear of your son's safety, and not from real intent to injure.
Alice, please!
Fine. Charles, Jeremy, we're leaving.
But Mom...
That's enough. Jeremy, now!
Carly, are you all right?
Nothing that putting my fist in that woman's face won't cure.
I'm certain her concern for her child is what precipitated that behavior. Think nothing more of it.
Was she right, though?
Right? Right about what, my good man?
Did you have anything to do with that boy's situation?
Are you inferring that we deliberately put that young man in danger for our own amusement?
You two had better just keep to yourselves. When this storm lifts, I think it would be best if you found other accommodations for your holiday.
Gladly.
Good evening, gentlemen.
By the way, Doctor, I'm curious. Have you had any nightmares since you came here? Headaches?
Nightmares? Whatever do you mean? Neither of us have even been here for a full day yet.
That's interesting.
What are you implying?
I think I'm being rather clear about it.
Oh, for the love of... I'm out of here. This place could fall into a black hole and I wouldn't care.
Alice, I can't believe you. The Doctor and Carly saved Jeremy's life and you go after them like a nutter!
Don't you use that tone on me. I need some aspirin. My head is killing me.
If it's really this bad, then why don't we just leave? This can't be good for Jeremy. We came here to try and fix our relationship, not make it worse.
Mom? Dad? Can't we all just go to bed? I'm sleepy and my head hurts.
In a moment, Jeremy. Alice, are you even listening to me?
Tell me why I should be listening and I'll get back to you on that.
Alice, the counselor said we were supposed to talk about things while we were here on holiday. I know it's been stressful. Why make it any worse? We'll just pack up and go.
And where are we supposed to go? The car's not working in case you'd forgotten. And we had to leave it miles down the road. What do you expect us to do? Walk all the way to the next town?
Better than staying here.
There's plenty of food, and the fireplaces can keep us warm until the hotel staff gets everything fixed. I think you just want to go and find someone else. Any excuse to get away from Jeremy and I.
Alice.
Dad.
Jeremy, I'm sorry. I'm trying to talk to your mum.
Daddy, I'm really sleepy. I really am.
Jeremy? Jeremy!
Was I? Did I just fall asleep? Or am I awake? I'm confused. When did I get to my bedroom? I thought we were at the castle. Dad? Mom? Is that you? Dad?
Alice, put that chair down!
Mom? Mom, why are you holding a chair like that?
None of your business, Jeremy! Get back to your room!
But Dad!
But Dad! Spare me. Why did we think it was a good idea to have a kid again?
Mom! Mom, what do you mean?
We wouldn't have had a kid if you hadn't whined about having one to save our marriage. So technically, isn't he your fault?
Oh, for crying out loud. He's blubbering. Look what you did, Charles.
He gets that from you, you know. You're both whiners.
Say that again, I dare you. If it wasn't for the brat, I'd just leave you and move on with my life. But I can't because of him.
Mom!
Mom! Oh, look, he can't handle the truth, can you, Jeremy? Can't handle reality where Mommy and Daddy can't get along, can you?
Daddy? Dad, what are you... Dad, you sound funny.
Really? You aren't wanted. And what point is there in being where you're not wanted? You should just give up, Jeremy. Give up everything and let yourself drift into the dark.
Dad? Dad, what are you saying? Dark? What's in the dark?
Everything, Jeremy. Everything is here. The end to your pain. The fighting, everything. If you give in, you won't have to deal with this anymore. No more pain. More yelling, just nothingness.
But, I don't like the dark. There are always monsters there.
There are no monsters in the dark, Jeremy. Just me. Just me and nothingness. Let go, and all your pain will go away.
Let go, and all my pain will go away.
That's right, Jeremy. Just let go. What are you?
What? What's going on?
No! You can't take him! He's mine! Don't wake him up! He's mine!
What?
You can't stop me! I'll eventually take you and everyone else! I'll take you all!
Jeremy? Jeremy! You just fell asleep and then you wouldn't wake up. Oh, thank goodness you're okay.
Dad? Dad, what happened? Was I asleep? You kept telling me to go to the dark. And you said you and Mom never wanted me.
Jeremy, that's just not true.
Jeremy, listen, I love you. Your mom loves you. There is no way we would ever say anything like that. I thought the dreams you were having... I'm having them too. Need to figure out what's going on.
Why don't you go and ask your precious doctor for help?
Would you shut up for once in your life?
But Dad, that thing... It was using your voice. I've heard it before when I was on the terrace. And then the doctor stopped it somehow.
I knew the doctor was involved with all this somehow. He'll get his own. You mark my words, he will.
Tell me why we didn't just go back to the kid's room. For wanting to get answers from him so much, it seems we're going the wrong way. For starters, we're outside.
I'm not quite sure that right now is the best time to ask questions of the lad, Carly. He's upset, and his parents seem rather agitated. I'd prefer to talk to him when he is calmed, and when his mother and father are not around.
So they can't yell at you?
Perhaps. But if I'm going to make any progress, I think it would be better if we made ourselves scarce for a while. No use agitating an already tense situation.
I still say you're afraid of his parents.
As you will believe. Now. Ah. What's this? A cell phone. Dead. Let me see here. How odd.
What is it?
Whatever's affecting the local electronics apparently also affects my sonic screwdriver. Very unusual indeed.
I'm not sure I feel comfortable out here anymore. My headache is back.
Don't worry, Carly. We shall find what is affecting this place and set things right, I assure you.
I've heard that before. Doctor!
Yes, Carly, what is it? Oh, dear. It looks like...
It's a body.
For being dead, he seems very alive. That's always rather a good thing, I'd say.
What?
Hello. Are you all right? We found you out here in the forest.
People. You both. Your eyes are open. You can see me. And you're not him.
Well, of course we can see you. Are you sure you're not hurt,
Stuart. I'm fine. Just a headache.
You work here? Your apron says you're from the Amberley Kitchens.
Well, Stuart, I must say it's very good to see you out and about. You very nearly gave my friend Carly a bit of a fright there. She thought you were dead.
Almost wish I was.
Why would you say that?
Came out here to get away from him. He made me dream horrible, horrible things. The things that I can't stop remembering.
Someone made you have bad dreams? Who?
The Somnium.
The Somnium? He made you dream bad things. And you tried to run away. Is that why you're out here?
Yes. I had to get away. The other staff laughed at me. But all I could see when I closed my eyes was the blood. The blood! I had to get away.
Stuart, do you know that your co-workers are worried about you? I heard them talking when I got here. They're not sure what happened to you.
Let me see here. Every time you go to sleep, you have a nightmare, is that right? Carly, when I awoke you earlier, you seemed rather upset. Are you having a nightmare as well?
Yes, I don't really want to talk about it, though.
I'm very sorry, my dear. But I may need you to if we are to figure out what's going on here. so everyone seems to have had headaches. You know, there's been an odd buzzing noise in my head since I arrived. And then, whenever someone falls asleep, there's a mention of nightmares.
The somnium is doing it. He is awful. Terrible.
But what gain would there be in giving people nightmares? And that doesn't explain the mechanical blackouts either.
He's coming. My head. My head hurts so much.
Stuart, did you want to sit down?
Carly, did you bring your satchel with you?
No. I was a little busy to be worrying about my purse, Doctor.
He is coming. He is coming. The pain.
Stuart? Stuart, maybe you'd better lie down instead of just sitting.
Just lying down for a moment. My eyes. Just shut them.
No, Stuart! You must not fall asleep. You've got to fight it. Wherever this thing is that brings the nightmares, going to sleep will be exactly what it wants.
Too tired. Doctor.
Stuart!
Aha! Now I find the source of the interference.
Stuart! Stuart, wake up!
That's not Stuart talking, I'm afraid. Well, do I have the pleasure of speaking to the Somnium? Is it the one who's behind all this?
Guilty as charged, little primitive.
I don't know what game you're playing, but I insist that you leave the body of my friend here this very instant. We can discuss what you want in a civilized manner after you release him.
Leave. Now why would I want to do that?
Oh, my head!
Just getting started.
Stop it! Please!
Just what do you think you're doing?
Whatever I want, of course. What else would I do? Honestly, I don't understand why you even concern yourself in the first place. You're an off-worlder, like I am. Of what value are these humans to you?
Value? Value! They are living beings! That is their value! And even more, the people of this planet are rare, enchanting creatures. I take personal offense at anyone who interferes with them! Now, I will not say it again! You are to leave these people in peace! Now!
You would dare challenge me, little primitive? I am the Summoner! What I wish to happen, happens. And no doctor is going to stand in my way.
My head... it's killing me.
Stop it! You've made your point!
Not yet. But I'm about to.
Stuart, no! What are you doing?
Enough! Enough! That's enough! If you go through with this, you and I will have moved beyond negotiation. For the last time, leave him be!
Such weak creatures. So easily controlled.
He's going to kill himself. Doctor, stop him. Stuart!
Stuart! Stuart, fight it! Fight it! Your will is your own. No one controls you. No one!
All of them will die, Doctor. The stones of Amberley will bleed red. You can't save them. Just like you can't save your friend.
Stuart!
Help me.
I'm so sorry.
That monster!
Carly, my dear, are you all right?
I don't know. My head feels like it's on fire. I can barely see straight.
Here, lean on me.
Doctor, what are we going to do? If that thing has the power to make people kill themselves...
We'll get back to the castle and get everyone away from here as quickly as possible. In the TARDIS if we have to. I don't know exactly what the Somnium is planning, but time must be running out if he is so willing to show himself so overtly now.
Okay, Doctor. I want to go home.
Soon, Carly, soon.
You have been warned, Doctor.
And so have you, Somnium. So have you.
Please, Doctor. Slow down. This headache makes me want to be sick.
It's not that much further, I promise. Just hold on a little longer.
You keep saying that. And how come you're not affected like the rest of us seem to be?
I say it to keep you moving. As to the pain, I suspect the Somnium is unable to use his mental abilities on me as he does with humans. I do keep hearing that buzzing sound in my mind, however.
Lucky. I wish that I could go to sleep. And the pain would stop.
That That's the Somnium's doing, Carly. You can fight it.
I don't know, Doctor. I'm so tired.
Oh, okay, we're here. Sit still a moment.
Doctor, I thought you'd... You should probably leave. Alice is here, and I don't think it's a good idea for you to be here.
Mr. Pingott, I need you to gather your family and come with us. Everyone is to leave Castle Amberley at once.
What are you talking about? Leave? Leave how? All our cars are stuck miles away and don't work. How do you expect us to leave?
TARDIS.
What? What's she saying?
My TARDIS. We can use it to leave this place.
What's a TARDIS? Some new Japanese import? You do seem feverish, you poor thing. Perhaps you need to lay down.
Dad? What's going on?
Jeremy, I thought I told you to stay away from the door.
Doctor? Carly? What are you doing here?
I guess there's no helping it. Get inside.
Thank you kindly. Here, Carly, take my hand.
I'll help.
Hey, I'm not a total invalid. Thanks, Jeremy. That was a really big help. Think you can get me to that chair?
Sure!
Charles, what are they doing here?
I don't know, but Carly here doesn't look very well, so I'd suggest you shut your trap and work on speaking kindly. The doctor may have an idea on getting us out of here. I thought bringing them inside for a spell would be okay.
You thought that? You would, wouldn't you?
Alice, please.
Mom, what's the problem? They just need our help, like they helped me.
Fine. Just fine. Have it your way. If they're staying, I'm leaving.
Alice, don't! I'm sorry for that. She's been acting like this even worse than usual since we came here. And I'm terribly sorry for all the things she said earlier, too.
I can see that. But there's more to Castle Amberley than meets the eye, I'm afraid. It's likely affecting your wife.
Doctor? Jeremy, I bet you have a lot of cool toys. Can I see them?
Okay.
I don't think you're a fool, Doctor. You know something. What is it?
I'm not entirely sure, Mr. Pingott. All I know at the moment is that he calls himself the Somnium. He spoke through your son, and we heard him again through one of the kitchen boys.
Stuart?
Yes. Mr. Pingott, you should know that the Somnium then killed that young lad.
What?
Jeremy is in very grave danger, I'm afraid.
Then, we're extremely lucky that you were both here when Jeremy... Alice may not realize how much she owes to you, but I surely do. Thank you so much for saving my son's life.
We have very little time left. I have a vehicle, just barely outside the castle walls. The Somnium will not have influence on it. We will use it to escape this place.
And go where? If this thing can reach us in our minds...
Best guess is that he has chosen this place for a reason. The Somnium has gone to a lot of trouble to keep you here, shutting down the electricity, as well as these nightmares and headaches. All are part of a larger plan.
Jeremy?
Yes, Dad?
Get your jacket. We're going to leave.
Oh, thank goodness. We're finally getting out of here.
Leave? Leave where?
Yes, Carly.
Somewhere away from the castle.
Will Mom be coming too?
Yes, we'll get her along the way. We're all leaving. Everyone here.
Jeremy, do you remember any of the time before we caught you on that terrace?
Remember?
There was a voice coming from you that wasn't yours. Do you remember?
No, I don't really. I remember Mom being upset, though.
We should get moving. You can ask more questions after we get into that transport of yours.
Yes, come along then.
Carly, do you need a hand?
No, thank you. I think I can manage.
Whoever could that be?
I'll get it.
Alice? The bellboy?
Their eyes.
Alice? Alice, are you all right?
They're asleep, Doctor. They're asleep, just like Stuart was outside.
So that's how this goes. Is this your work, Somnium?
Where do you think you're going?
I'm taking them far away from this place where you can't harm them. And then I will be back to deal with you.
Alice! Alice, wake up!
You know, my dear, things will go much better if you stop fighting. There's nothing to be afraid of. Here in the dark, the Somnium makes everything better.
Mom?
Alice, please, you're scaring your son.
So?
Your son should have given in when he had the chance. Then you wouldn't have had to see this.
You stay away from my boy!
Doctor, what are we going to do?
You had your chance. You could have left on your own and leave me with these humans. But it doesn't look like you can mind your own business.
I will never abandon these people to you.
It's always more fun when they struggle.
Doctor?
Stop it! Stop it, Mommy! I'll be good, just stop it!
Time to stop fighting, Doctor. Time for it to end for good.
Doctor!